Taping today. We spoke about it on the phone.
It's HBO. You realize it's 8 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, we said 8 o'clock. 8 a.m. Remember?
It's supposed to be 8 p.m.
No, I said
box office at 8 p.m.
I said we might be shooting until 8 p.m., Mr. Chase, but in fact, we're here at 8 a.m. to start shooting. And we're checking out the location now.
To start shooting what?
Yes. How are you feeling?
How am I feeling? How do I look? I'm feeling very tired.
Well, we're here to run some tests and, you know, get the
show. For what? What are you talking about?
We had a phone conversation about 2 days ago.
Are you talking about the day in the life thing, following me around for a day in my life to get a sense of
Chase? That's why we're here. It's nice to see you.
Well, I think it's a little earlier and might be the wrong day to start.
No, it's 8 a.m. as you agreed on the phone, and we're all set up outside. Our trucks are here. Our men are here.
All right. Look, come in.
Yes.
But no tricks. Hold it right there.
Sure.
Now, let me get this straight now. Right now.
Whatever you want to know.
You're not taping anything now, is that clear?
Mr. Chase.
I don't want anybody pulling my leg.
You have my word. There's no tape in that camera. We're here to do readings, light readings.
Okay, you're just doing light readings and getting a sense of the house.
Right, remember we spoke.
Get a sense of the pool area where I want you guys to get out there by the pool. I haven't really cleaned the house that much, so please.
It doesn't matter because we're just testing now.
All right, but there's no tape.
No
tape.
You have my word on that.
All right. Come in. Let me get showered and shaved.
Go ahead. You do what you do, Mr. Chase, and we'll do what we do.
Okay, that's a good idea. But do what you do out by the pool, and I'll just do what I do in here.
We have men out at the pool now doing some light readings.
Very good, okay. No.
We're going to get out there later.
No.
We're going to shoot some stuff out
there. You seem to misunderstand me. Excuse me?
What's the matter?
I would like you to shoot, if you will, please, out and around the pool and get a sense of the lighting there. This is kind of my private area.
Mr. Chase, can I assure you that it's necessary that we check the lighting in this room as well as the other rooms? And if there are people at the pool now, we appreciate it. And we know that you
there's no tape here?
You have my word, I promise you. No tape, okay?
Home box office, I know, you know, so. Let's go directly to the bathroom area.
It's your house.
We will be using the bathroom.
We're your guests.
In fact, it's a kind
of
nice
house. We want to see how you are.
Come right in.
We want to see what you do in your own home, in your own setting.
I want you to be seen.
In your own surroundings.
I will want you in the bathroom, please.
Okay.
Can we go in there?
Sure.
This is my wife. Thank you.
Oh, well, and she might want to be in the show.
She will be in the show. I think she'll be enjoying it.
Very much.
Thank you.
It's nice to see her.
Let's just stay with me if we can for most of the day.
Absolutely. We're talking about
going. Let me talk to you. I'll talk at you for a second.
Okay, whatever you want to
cover the day.
I'm here to listen to
when
you.
I'm through with the showering and the shaving.
Right.
Let's get there right down to the children's hospital.
Uh-huh.
Have the suit on.
There's a crew there now waiting.
You're good.
That's
you're
covered.
And there you do have tape.
Yes.
Of course.
This is just a test.
What are you doing?
See, this is a test to see the sound level.
I'm brushing my teeth, but you can't get sound level.
Brushes are perfect sound testers. It gives you the highs. It's very good. Trust me, it's a test, Mr. Chase, okay? Just go about what you're doing.
We get better mid-range out by the pool. You can get your mid-range,
well,
you can get your lows.
We'll certainly do that.
Do I have to have this in my face? Can I put it down, please?
You may put it down.
I'm going to put it right here. We'll leave it here. You can be real safe, okay?
Okay. Thank you, Chase. We appreciate it.
Jesus Christ, man.
We appreciate your cooperation. Also, my pleasure. Also, we're going to go to the college for the dedication.
Pleasure is all yours. You know?
Certainly.
Hey!
Mr. Chase?
Go!
Yes. Just, you know, we want to see how
you got light readings in there. Can we stick with here?
Well, we have to get it from every angle.
All right. Now, Children's Hospital.
Right.
We agree on that. UCLA, the Cancer Center.
Right.
I want to be there for the dedication, the cornerstone thing.
And you're going
to
be
zip over to Saginaw after. Check signing.
And also, Mr. Chase, we'll have that sequence with the comedians.
No tape. Am I wrong or right?
My word, okay?
Okay, that's it. I'll never say it again.
I just wanted
to reiterate
it. Let me promise.
None of this is on tape. This is
kind
of my private life. Okay, you got your sound checks.
This is a test. And then you're going to go to the club and talk with the comedians. That sequence.
Yep.
Okay?
Yep.
So
that's one day. Get the kids.
That's the day. No, the kids are covered. Everything's covered.
Excuse me.
And we appreciate
Let's just talk to each other.
Well, we're going to see what's going on all around your life. You know? It's a day in the
My wife is showering, if you don't mind.
Okay. She'll also be in the show. Anyway, we're going to take some sound levels also around the house. And
Very nice.
I want to see how everything plays.
That's a great idea.
I want to see how you play
that's
in the house.
That's a great idea.
I want to see how the lights play in the house and the sound, okay?
Uh-huh.
So just feel like we're a part
all
of
right.
the house.
All right, let me just suggest this, and this is my house, as you say. My home is this cow.
Absolutely.
I would like you to get out by the pool area.
Uh-huh.
right away to directly to the garden and pool because we can use that place for the disco dance thing later by the fountain. Do you like it?
The colored lights by the fountain.
Yep.
Disco.
Yep. I think it's going to work perfectly.
See, I know we work well together, Mr. Chase.
Okay, I'm just going to go to the rest room and take a rest.
Okay.
So you get out.
We're gonna go to the pool.
We're gonna
just look around.
Excellent. Okay.
Okay, go right
out.
Right,
a lot of tests.
To the pool. A
lot of tests.
Okay, get on out there to the pool.
Yeah,
right
we're gonna go right out to the pool.
Listen, while you're out in the garden area and the pool, why don't you use the other camera and shoot around and enjoy yourself?
Okay, we're gonna do just that. I wanna get some shots of the tile, the plants, the walls, the chairs, everything.
All of that, enjoy it. And
I wanna see everything. What?
Do me a favor, please.
What's that?
There are rhododendrons out there.
Yeah?
Please try not to get stuck on them or break anything.
Okay, we'll be very careful. Did you grow them yourself?
Yes, we grow our own, and we're very careful of them, and also the lawn and the grass.
Looks high quality. Looks
sorry,
real good.
What did you say?
I want to talk to you about these plants.
I try not to step
on
the
grass. We've got quite a variety here.
Thank you. I very much appreciate you staying
outside. I've appreciated everything,
like
Mr.
This,
Chase.
Even though you're just doing tests.
There's so much here to see and take in.
Darn mess. Like a waterfall?
Yeah, well, the gardener's over there now.
Well, ask him to help you out if you need anything.
I can't understand him.
I can't understand you.
I can't understand the gardener.
The gardener wants me?
I can't understand
or talk. I cannot understand you.
What did you say?
I'm going to talk to you with the gardener, okay?
What?
I'm coming out.
Yeah, okay, sure, fine. Well, yeah, you don't have to, but...
Yeah. What happened to the, other camera then, you just used
to... Oh, we put that in the truck, Mr. Chase.
Oh, you got all your necessary readings out here? Isn't it lovely? Bernie, you're not listening, Bernie. 15% of what, man? Of course we win. They do not roll tape there, you dope. They didn't roll tape. No, of course not. We went right to the children's hospital, and I did everything I was supposed to do. I gave them some money. I talked to the fucking kids.
Chase, it's locked. Can you open it for me? Chase.
Can you open it for me here? It's locked and I can't get at it. You have to open it. What is it? Sorry. Just a minute. Can you open the lock for Mr. Chase? What is it? I'll get it. No problem. All right, I'll call you back. All right, no, I don't believe that's my prerogative. Okay, thank you too. Can you give the man a room, please? Mr. Chase is not a circus freak. He's an artist. Let's give him some room. He gives so much to you, so let's just not block him. They're giving me room very fast, Tom.
They're giving me a lot of room very fast, Tom. Well, did you see any autographs, stuff, or anything like that?
Thank you. Excuse me. Thank you for coming tonight. I'd like to introduce the first comic tonight. I want you to know that these are people I've seen rarely. And who are, I think, the best at what they do. This stand-up comedy is not an easy thing. It takes a long time, a lot of workouts, And this is a man, and I want to be honest with you. When he told me, hum, box office, they said, Chevy, you pick him. Do you know what I mean? Hi, what's your name? My hometown. And I said, I'm going to pick the best goddamn comedy stand-up people I've ever seen. Forget the heat. And the man who came is the first person I picked. His name is Bill Kirkenbauer. I don't know if you've seen him. He's been on The Tonight Show. No, please, wait. And He's brilliant at what he does. I went right to Bill and I said, Bill, you. And I'd like to bring him out now, if I may. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bill Kirkenbauer.
Good evening. I'd like to start out by doing a couple impressions for you. My first impression is that of a Los Angeles garbage truck at 7:30 in the morning. Hey man, you make sure everybody be sleeping.
Me?
Good. I like to listen to noises. There are a lot of strange noises in the world if you listen to them. Does anybody know, for example, what the most hated instrument in the world is? Bagpipes, right. Accordion's number two, bagpipes is number one. I don't dislike the bagpipes. I just think they're kind of a weird instrument. What gets me is somebody had to invent the thing. A guy had to say to himself one day,
oh, let's see if we can invent some sort of an obnoxious musical instrument. Something real disgusting. Let's see what happens if I blow on a vacuum cleaner.
To prevent the birth of new microphones. New from Popeil, giant moron rubber darts.
Maybe I can get a bullseye.
Hello, children, I'm home. Three sons. It's a new invention of mine. This is a stereo speaker for the deaf. I want to tell you about it. $6 million man at a discotheque doing the bump. Ha ha.
comedy right now. I'm going to get into ventriloquism, but I haven't got a lot of money, and I can't afford a real good dummy. So kind of bear that in mind, okay?
As long as we understand each other,
everything will be all right. This is Herman Gibner. Herman's a little bit different than you guys and me. He was born without a body. And he feels, huh? Oh, Herman likes you guys. He thinks you need. You want to sing a song for him? Okay. Sing the same old song that we always sing, okay? Okay. I'll start off. Maestro. She'll be coming around the mountain. She'll be round when she comes. She'll be round the mountain, coming to the mountain. She'll be round the mountain when she comes. Take it, Herman! She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes.
No, Herman, you can't have a body.
Every time we get on with a show, he thinks I make a lot of money, I can afford a body. No, you can't have a body. Besides, what would you do with a body if you had one? So, what do you want to do now? The life of a diaphragm. Film clip from my favorite movie of all time. I think you've been a very good audience. My last impression, since there's a lot of tourists here, a little preview for them if they go to Disneyland. It's my impression of the Matterhorn roller coaster ride at Disneyland.
ticket.
Thank you.
Thank you. My next guest is very funny. And I remember when I was asked to do this, this guy is a stand-up comic, unparalleled in the anals, and his name is Irv Burton. Yes, he's a Negro. Tom, cannot see Tom, but you'd help me understand. Not do it. The comedy stylings of Irv. Irv Burton.
Sorry, this is comedy. I disappoint you people.
Is it all right if I talk about films?
Yeah. It's okay.
I'm always fascinated by films, especially King Kong. Now, have you ever seen this dude, especially the second one? He looks like he's been on downers or something, you know? He be coming through the breeze like this. But if you ever watched the original one, this dude act like he had been on speed or something, you know?
He be coming through the breeze like this.
A major part in television when you think about it. You listen to community talk shows, they're very cool about coming on. Boom, 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 boom. What our special guests are this week. Boom, 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 boom. But if you ever listen to the black community talk shows, they have to jazz them up to let you know they're black. And they come on like this. Gullible Television 8, CBS in Cleveland. It's 4 o'clock. Black Jiggy's next. What's the show that's been getting down? A black Jiggy, what's the show that people come around? A black Jiggy, black and black and black, black Jiggy, black and black and black, black Jiggy. Now that time you say, oh my God, it's supposed to be black. What I'm waiting to see is when Aretha Franklin does a coffee commercial. Could you imagine? Honey, when my man comes home, the first thing he wants is a coffee on the table. So you know what I do, girl? I perk my lips up to say one thing. What you want? Baby, I got what you need. I have to ECP. I don't want to make something. I have to ECP. Take care of me, city. Respect coffee, honey. Thank you, Rita. Singers, you know, singers are weird, especially Joe Cocker. You ever watch him? He be going crazy on stage, you know. I'm going home. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Joe Cocker. See Joe the next day. Hey, how's it going, man?
Hey, it's going all right.
Sidney Poitier, now that's the dude that lays me out. He looks like he's high all the time. Because he looks paranoid when he does his thing. Let me know, you let know, you let know.
You see, Bill Cosby's cool, see, because he talks like this, you know what I mean, man?
My neighborhood, you can never get high. You know, my mother would have a fit. You're doing what? See, when I get to twitching, you know you were going to get a whooping, you know. But before that, you get what you call the two-minute warning. My sister would come in the room. Ooh, you go get it. Mama saw you in the backyard, you play her pots and pans. Ooh. You end up being in a coma, you know, oh my God. And your mother come in there, you know, she'd be on the front porch. Just come on around the front door, it's open. Playing my pots and pans. Uh-huh. Now, didn't I tell you not to do that no more? Come out from under there. My God. And you'd be in the bedroom, you'd be crying. I didn't mean to do it, Mama. I didn't mean to do it. Trying to tell your mother, come in and ask that dumb question. You want some more? That wasn't enough, huh? You want some more? Like you don't turn around with full energy and say, oh, sure, Mom, right up the back here, you know? I go for that kind of thing. And they always do these dumb things. You know, ask you dumb questions. You be in the bathroom. What are you doing in there? I'm working on the sign project. Can you wait 5 years, Mom? Oh, well, you want to borrow some money, say $15, you know? Hey, Mom, can I borrow $15? For what?
Hey, the guy down the street got a sell on drugs. Thought maybe I'll stock up for the holidays.
Yeah, boy. Ooh, so how y'all feel? Y'all feel good?
Yeah.
Feeling good? You have to excuse me, I'm sweating so much.
Oh, is that Richard Pryor back there?
No.
Woodman back, Woodman Jack out there. All right.
All right now. Okay. Okay, now that I brought
the tempo down. Let's move into some slow cosmic comedy, huh? Okay. Now, this is the true story between King Kong and Godzilla. The actual fight. Stage, you know, you can get away with talking to the ladies, you know. You know, it's, hey, how you doing? Want to go to Zambo's after the show? You try to do that off stage. Hey, how you doing? Get away from me! No, I don't have a name! I'm sorry, I was just trying to get past in line. I didn't mean that, you know. In our neighborhood, we had a lot of characters, you know. A lot of people used to wonder, what was the gangs doing, you know? Why was they drinking wine, and what was they talking about, and what happened to them, you know? They'd be standing on the corner, drinking their wine.
Oh, wow, man. Getting on this wine is real slick, you know?
Yeah, man, I figured, you know, after we get drunk, you know, we gone and beat up somebody, you dig?
Yeah, man, but the way I kind of figure is that maybe we should just break up this gang and start us a singing group.
Yeah!
Yeah, man, and then after me, man, it'd be your turn.
Yeah, man! We'd be real cool! Check us out!
Ladies and gentlemen, y'all make a problem. The fabulous mechanism of an eruption! We're here to blow your mind, mama. You sit back and relax and let me do it for you.
Day in and day out, sometimes I think I've lost. Oh, I've got on this girl of mine, sure not my fault, yeah.
So the other day, I walked in with a jar.
I don't care what the people say, I got to get up on my side. I just keep on searching in vain. Hada, 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 hey! I just keep on searching. Low, 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 hey! I just keep on searching.
I have a Chinese laundryman. Thank you. And this is a guy who, this is true. This is a guy who, got my eyes? Who?
Come on, Kim.
Thank you. Okay. Who burns my laundry a lot, loses all of it, and then is abrasively assertive about it. He is arrogant enough to make me ostensibly believe that it's my fault. And overcharges. I mean, it's not... Pardon you? And last night I got this call about 4 a.m. from this guy. And I think it went something like this. Ring.
Hello, Mr. Chase?
Hello?
Are you up?
Who is this?
That woke you up? It's Mr. Lee, your laundryman.
My laundryman. Mr. Lee, what time is it?
What, you're sleeping?
I'm sleeping. What time is it?
What time is it? Hold on, you check. That's all right. I'm taking a break.
It's 4:25.
Hold on a minute.
4:25, Mr.
4:25?
Yes.
Oh. Well, I'm calling Mr. Chase because you forgot to pay your bill. $4.80.
Mr. Lee.
Can you run it down? Because I'm quitting early today.
Mr. Lee, I...
Like about 5 in the morning or something, I'll have a banish?
I will not be paying the bill. As you know, you're losing the laundry, all of it. You're burning my shirts a lot.
That's right, yeah. So, I do my part, you gotta do your part. Meet me halfway.
Mr. Lee, my laundry, where is my laundry? What's going on here? It's late, very late.
Well, we burn your laundry. We had to burn your laundry. We folded and burned it.
Yes, you have been folding my laundry and burning it and losing it.
By the
it.
Way, before I forget, the laundry that you brought in there last week?
Yes.
I couldn't possibly lose it till Tuesday.
Yes.
Maybe I'll burn it Friday, but no promises. But let's try.
It's very late in the
I'll
morning.
I'll burn part of it.
Hello? Mr. Lee?
Your dime.
It's a collect call now here.
Hello?
I'm late. I'm sleeping and you're calling me very late. Yeah. Okay.
Early in the morning.
Yes, I...
Well, yeah. I'm going on vacation, too. Wanted to ask you if you go to your beach house this summer.
I will be.
You want to be out there swimming, getting wet?
I'll be at my beach house later,
when,
yes.
When are you going to be there?
I'll be going out this week on a Friday, I think.
Friday?
Friday, Mr. Lee.
I'll be there Thursday.
Mr. Lee, I can't stick around.
Up on your sheets?
You're just going to let me know you're there, kind of?
Sure, like that. I'll fold and burn your towels. On the ground.
Mr. Lee, I'm not coming down today. I want to thank you for calling me.
Are you going to pay your bill?
No, I will not be paying the bill until we get to a lawyer here.
Well, I'll talk to my people. One last thing before I go.
A lot of them to talk to. Yeah, go ahead.
Hello?
Hello?
Mr. Lee? There?
Yes, I'm here. Go on, I want to hang up.
All right. Do you want your laundry lost on a hanger or folded and burned?
Are we rolling tape, Marty?
Yes, we can take the race car.
Okay. What can I say? Denny Johnson.
First thing I want to ask is,
do I look okay?
Yeah.
Good. You like the suit?
Yeah.
And my hair looks okay?
Yeah.
Good. I want to take this hot shit off.
Right.
I'm in a semi-good mood.
Good. I want to start.
When I'm in a good mood, I usually like to sing, and I'm in a good mood tonight, so I'd like to open with this little song. My favorite girl, she's a Czechoslovakian, and I'm a nervous wreck. I took her home to meet my folks, but my folks said they don't accept checks. I like to play tricks on people. You know, it's fun to do to people that own telephone answering machines. Next time you call and a machine answers, make the owner of the machine think something's wrong with it by leaving him a message like this.
Oh, it's me. Sorry, I was home, but don't worry. I'll call you back again.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, here's another neat thing to do to people that own big Cadillacs or big station wagons. Next time you're in a crosswalk and someone's waiting at a light, take out a coin out of your pocket and walk across the crosswalk, flipping it like this. And as soon as you get in front of their car, drop it and go.
Then get down low, then crawl along the passenger side of the car and run out the back.
Then when the light turns green, watch them. They go, honk, honk. Works every time. Have you ever had a police car pull up next to you at a stoplight and give you one of these looks?
And you've done nothing wrong, but they make you feel guilty. Most people get these guilt feelings, you know, and they try to cover them up by doing things like, or they, look at their watch. Oh, gotta be to work. Or they'll sit there and play with the radio stations, you know, singing along. I'm not a criminal. But it never seems to work. They always detect fear and then they pull you over. If you never want to get pulled over by the police, just sit behind your steering wheel and do this. I know it's gross, but it works. See, the police don't want to pull you over and give you a ticket because subconsciously neither one of them wants you to touch his pen.
Okay, buddy, you want to sign right here? Well, forget it. Just keep it under 100, okay?
I like doing impressions. How many of you like Jack Nicholson? Nicholson is, he is so great, and I think that his career will go on forever, you know, but you never know in this business. Your career can take a nosedive anytime, and I think that if for some reason, Jack, just a minute, could I get a sip of someone's beer or anything? Just.
That's Jim.
Yeah. I shouldn't smoke those two lids on the way down here. Anyway, I was talking about, oh, wow, I could have had a V8. Anyway, I think if Jack Nicholson ever, let's say he couldn't get a job in a movie, and the only job offered to him was hosting a kiddie show, this is how I think Nicholson would handle it.
Why didn't I go to college?
Right, you little turd droppers. Now, before we start to tape the show today, Uncle Jack wants to talk to you kids about a few things that are pissing him off. First of all, I'm tired of you guys coming here to this show drunker and shit. I don't want to find any more quaaludes on the floor either. If I do, Uncle Jack's gonna have to put his hands around your little necks and squeeze till your fucking eyes pop out. Thank you very much. Well, let's see. How many of you remember America's Favorite Family? Anybody? Who said the Mansons? Yeah, you all remember Ozzie Manson, don't you? Wonder what Ricky Manson would be like. Rick Manson. Hey, Dave, let's cut up Wally. No, it was the Nelsons. You all remember Ricky Nelson, don't you? The teenage idol of the 50s. He's a good-looking guy, but he had no earlobes. I can't imagine. I think if they ever got Rick Nelson to do a television commercial, there would be only one product that Ricky could sell, and that would be this product right here.
Thank you.
This is Rick Nelson. Hey, you know, when the Nelsons get hungry... which is all day long. We usually go down the mall shop and have a burger or two. But not anymore. Not since Mom's been buying this crap. New hamburger helper. Now all she does is goes to the market, buys a pound of ground round, or GR. Takes it home, puts it in the skillet, cooks it up real, 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 real good. Puts in salt and pepper. Heck, sometimes even a little bit of oregano. Then for real good flavor, Mom always tosses in a box of hamburger helper. But Dave and Wally and Thorny and Chris and I always say, gee, Mom, you're pretty stupid. Heck, you ought to take that shit out of the box first. So remember, gang, this is Rick Nelson singing. Don't laugh, I've done a lot of proms. Perfect. Yes, it's all right now. I learned my lessons well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. So buy a hamburger helper, pick up a box or two. But watch out, Mom, don't be surprised when the kids throw it up on you. Cheap fucking Hondas. Lucy, I'm home. I don't even want to be a stand-up comedian. I'm just doing this till I can get a manager job over at Pioneer Chicken. And... hey, how many of you like John Denver? How many of you don't like John Denver?
Well, great, then most of you are gonna like this song.
Oh, it's amazing. Seems like every 3 days, John Denver, or I call him Pumpkin Face. No. I'm just kidding. This is all in fun, okay? I have to say that. He's got enough money in his left pocket to say, have that asshole killed. Anyway, I think John Denver's written some beautiful songs, but I think he's putting them out now on a production line basis. And I think if he doesn't slow down, his next big hit single might sound something like this. Living in the Rocky Mountains used to be fun, but now I'm kicked back because my work's all done. Thanks to RCA, I can sit on my buns. Thank God I'm a millionaire. Now you won't see me square dancing at the Grange, and I ain't got blisters, I'm riding on the range. I got all my money in the stock exchange. Thank God I'm a millionaire. Well, I got me a Porsche and a new Maserati, because every song I sing turns into a hottie. I'm even making money while I'm sitting on the potty. Fire out! Thank God I'm a millionaire. Yeah!
Chucky, baby!
Oh, boy. let's see. Pretty soon you're gonna see my name up in flashing lights in every major city across the country. I'm changing it to Don't Walk. Okay. Now this guitar, I bought this guitar, it's a hand-built guitar, you know. I love the sound of it, but it won't stay in tune. I can practice with the thing all day long, it stays perfectly in tune. But as soon as something important comes up, it goes out of tune. Usually happens like every time I play for the president. All right, I've never actually ever played for the president. I mean, we've jammed together a few times. This is my impression of Jimmy Stewart singing the Beatles song Blackbird.
Piece of shit. Now, Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Now take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You've only waited for this moment to arrive.
I'll stop there. You don't want to hear the whole song. Okay.
If I could love you just one more time, I'd send my blues away. I'd send my blues away just to love you one more time. I took the warmth and the love and the laughter, but I only gave you pain. Took away the sun and made it rain. I'm an asshole. I'm an asshole. That shouldn't bother you, 'cause you're an asshole too.
Thank you, folks. You've been lovely. Thank you.
The next person who comes up here, I think, is the best, quite frankly, at this stuff, stand-up comedy. And I think you'll know it the minute he comes out here. Ken has been working in New York, out of the Comedy Store there. Do they have a comedy store in New York? Out of the improvisation, out of the Catch a Rising Store. And to this day, Catch a Rising Star. And to this day, I think he is probably the top young comic we have in this. I'm sorry, once again, it's Richard Belzer. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Richard Belzer.
Hello, 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 hello. Can I make these lights a little brighter? I like to go blind. Okay, thank you very much. Good. Blind comic. Okay, thank you. Great. I'm in a good mood tonight. I was a little. Can you make a little more feedback? Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, great. That's great.
I'm going to pump up the laps now so you feel a little better.
You feel a little better now?
Well, I came and I feel much better. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to sway back and forth for no apparent reason. Thank you. And now, I'd like to do a few my impression, ladies and gentlemen, of the ex-president of the United States, Gerald Ford. Thank you for that courtesy applause. And now, do you ever notice that all male nightclub singers do the same move when they come out? They'll give you this move, right? Everything's gonna be okay as soon as I get my neck fixed. I noticed it. Anyway, I'd like to do a finale, ladies and gentlemen, my impression of Michelangelo. This is my impression of Michelangelo. Ceilings, nothing more than ceilings. Get it? Good. Okay, and now, I'd like to do a few my impression of the film Earthquake. Hey, that was real scary, wasn't it? Okay, and now, ceilings. Those singers are great. My favorite singers are the guys that sing at weddings and bar mitzvahs. Those are the best singers. They always make every song sound the same. You know those guys that have Glenn Platt tuxedos and they go, well, river, water, little ball. Hey, I'm kind of like, you know, Cross the Guild Styles of Day. Yeah, sure. Anyway, I was at a wedding about, three weeks ago. It was a Jewish wedding. Jewish weddings are great because they always have Uncle Chuch come out and cut the challah. You know, that old guy always comes out. Kills about three people on the way to the thing. It's a hell of a way to start a marriage. You know what I'm saying? I guess not. Anyway, so I was at this wedding, and I was a little drunk from drinking champagne because, you know, champagne works faster because of the bubbles. So I was a little drunk, and this guy was saying, it's 2:45, sons of the clowns, bring out the bride and groom, cut the roast beef. And how much of this can you take? So I went over to the band leader, went right up to the band leader. You could see the net and the glue on his hairline. You know, one of those guys. I said, you guys take requests? He said, of course we do. I said, could you do something by the Rolling Stones? He said, yes, we can, young man. They'll have a seat. Now, I was goofing on the guy, but he was serious. And like 10 minutes later, this band leader turns to the orchestra at this wedding and says, boys, we have a request. The Rolling Stones medley, please. And they start playing a samba, right? Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. Hey, I've been around for many years. Gosh, you know, laid many a soul to waste. Pleased to meet you. Hope you kind of like, you know, guess my name. Because, hey, I can't get any, gosh, satisfaction. Gee, I can't get any satisfaction. And I'm driving in my car. And a man comes on the radio. Hey, he can't be a man because he doesn't smoke the same cigarettes as me. I can't get any, no satisfaction. Thank you. How about a hand for the band, ladies and gentlemen, the band. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. I want to bring my own people out. Claude Rains on piano, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, everything all right? What, did you want to deliver a message? It's a nice tie. They couldn't guess your weight, huh? Well, what are you going to do? those band singers are funny to me because they're the opposite of the real thing. The real thing is Mick Jagger. You ever see Jagger work? Jagger's like a rooster that took acid, you know?
No satisfaction.
Thank you. Thank you. If Mick Jagger gave me the satisfaction, I'm a fucking mummy. You know what I'm saying? Somehow I don't believe him. No satisfaction? Yeah, sure, Mick. Okay, fine. That's fine. Satisfy this. You know what I mean, pal? Good. Okay. No satisfaction, my ass. My hand's caught in my hair. Wait a minute. Fall down, we get up. Okay, thank you. And now, of course, you all know the Bob Dylan bar mitzvah tapes are now available. Imagine what Dylan's bar mitzvah must have sounded like. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam.
chair, kitty shiny, who melts for sub. Zoom, golly, 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 zoom, golly.
And his voice changes, right?
Lay, lady, lay. Playing my mouth for an hour.
Let me get that voice. I have a fantasy about Dylan I'd like to share with you. I feel that no matter how old Dylan gets, he'll continue to perform. This is my image, my fantasy. The 86-year-old Bob Dylan in concert. The old Dylan.
Oi! 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 Once upon a time, you dressed so fine, you threw your bums a dime in your prime, didn't you? People called Chevy the doll, you're bound to fall, you thought they was all kidding you. You still laugh about everybody that was hanging out. Now you don't laugh so loud, Mr. Big Shot, eh? Now you don't feel so proud about having to be scrounging your next meal. How does it feel like rolling gallstone? Thank you.
I can't work unless the wires on this side and the wall. No, I'm not gay, I'm not gay. I'm happy, but I'm not fucking gay. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying I wouldn't go down on Anita Bryant's husband, you know what I mean? I'd like to tie Anita Bryant in a chair and bring her husband in. Watch this, Anita. Tangerine. Okay, squeeze this, Anita, you know what I'm saying? Woman is the pits, okay? Thank you. And now, oh, Rochester, roll me a joint and turn on the stereo.
Okay, Mr. Benny, I got some Jamaican.
Jack Benny in Jamaica?
Okay, okay, I shot the sheriff, but I didn't shoot the deputy.
Can I have a cigarette? Thank you. Anybody can quit smoking. It takes a man to face cancer, okay? Real American mentality, right? Real bright. Sounds like Desi Arnaz's house, isn't it?
Babaloo! Hello, Lucy, don't come down to the club. Bell Fred and Ethel, so they care for little Ricky, and you can't be in the show, okay?
For 12 years, she couldn't be in the show, right?
You can't be in the show, you can't be in the show.
Finally, she got her own show. You know what I'm saying? These are nice matches, okay? Good. Captain Hook gave these to you, right? That's great. I'm gonna try this shit. If I get a buzz, then we talk price. No, I don't smoke pot. I use heroin. I'm sorry, I must have dozed off. Is there any mail for me? No, ma'am? You ever notice people have different styles of smoking a cigarette? Like, some people hold it like this. And if you see anybody do that, slap them, because it's stupid. I mean, what is this affectation? Give me a break with this, okay? Thank you. And in Europe, they give you this move, right? The Europeans?
When I was a little boy in France, I was not a little boy, I was a little girl. I was a little black girl. I was a dwarf. I was a little black French dwarf girl. And they wanted to brag in the show business, and they laughed at me. They said, how could you be in show business? You're a little black French dwarf girl. So I had a sex change operation, and they made me what I am today. A French male singer. Tell me if you can. What makes a man a man? In order to be a star, I could not stay in France. I had to come to America. I had to go to Broadway. That's the way you have to make it. I got on the boat in France, pulled in the harbor of New York. I saw the Statue of Liberty there, that defiant bitch with her arm in the air. Frankly, it gave me an erection, okay? Thank you. I got off the boat. I went to Times Square, the most famous corner in all of Broadway. I stood on the corner of Times Square. I sang my favorite song. I sang my best song. I sang my heart out for them. And they said to me, hey, pal, take a walk. You're blocking the fucking street, okay? Come on, let's go.
New York. New York will sober you up, you know what I'm saying? But if you think about it, France is the most sophisticated country in the world because even the fucking kids talk French in that country, you know what I'm saying? The children speak fluent French in that country, okay? The garbage men in that country are walking around talking French, okay? And I love French food. I had French fries in my dressing room before. And every Sunday, French toast. So I'm into the French thing, you know? Don't know why there is lipstick on my thigh. Sloppy blowjob. We sing them old, we sing them new, and now. The people have different ways of moving, you know. I figured out why black people walk the way they do. You know why black people walk the way they do? It's because for hundreds of years, black people were denied the use of white bathrooms. That's how the walkie bob. Like a black guy would go up to a white place and ask if he could use the bathroom.
Say, oh, can I use the bathroom?
No. So you see these guys on the corner think they're cool, they're not cool, they have to go into the bathroom.
I've been holding out so long.
You ever notice the black reporters on news shows get hired because they have white accents? You ever see those guys? Hi, I'm trying to avoid being black, so I don't know. Where's your old voice, Sparky? You know what I mean? I think they should have an authentic, natural, real person do the natural news. This is Rufus X with the news in your goddamn face. New York Police Department whipped some ass today. 172 dudes in blue stomped down, generally abused, molested, arrested, tortured, maced, whipped, kicked, punched, and hurt the feelings of Roscoe Brown. I have a special announcement tonight. The Italian cooking show has been canceled due to the oil shortage. So we bring you instead the Jive Gourmet. This is Rufus X with the food in your goddamn face. Tonight, from the Sammy Davis Jr. cookbook, I'm gonna teach you all how to make gefilte grits.
You should hire those people. They're more natural.
I'd like to keep you, ladies and gentlemen, my impression of Jack Nicholson going into Burger King for breakfast. Jack Nicholson.
Well, you can hold the pickle. And you can hold the lettuce. I want an omelet, no potatoes, tomatoes instead, and you can hold that big whopper between your knees, sweetheart.
Of course, thank you. You're way too kind, you know what I'm saying? Of course, you know that Nicholson's house was used in an unfortunate incident, and he had to testify in court about that, and it was on television a couple weeks ago. Nicholson in court.
Well, you know, Judge, Roman told me that she was 13 years old with the body of an 11-year-old. He took her up to my house, he gave her half a loot, he fucked her young brains out and told her he'd make her a star, and that's all I know, Judge. I'm renting that house.
Thank you. For those of you who felt my nose wrong with these glasses, I hate to disappoint you. And now, they don't. And now. And you ever notice that flying saucers are always seen in the south? They're never seen in the north. And it's always the same farmer that sees the flying saucer. It's the same guy. The reporter says, tell me, sir, what'd you see? And the farmer says, well, let me get this straight now. If I can just remember where I was, I can tell you what I saw. I believe I remember where I was now. Wait a minute. I got it for you. I was sitting up on the front porch, see? And my twin retarded boys was, they was carving their names in each other's feet. You know what I mean? Anyway, my wife was inside trying to find herself, okay? In a mirror. I never said she was a bright woman. I never even wished her that, okay? Anyway, you see her, my dog's taking a shit by that barn over there? There he goes. Go, Spot, go. Anyway, this cigar-shaped object come down out the sky, and this little bug-eyed green sumbitch got out. Well, he looked around, and he ate one of my hogs. And then he ate my wife. Well, she didn't mind that too much. Hey, you're a great audience. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, home box office. Thank you, America. Thank you, Chevy. Thank you.
Thanks for coming. Quite honestly, when you all leave, we're going to pick up all the stuff I did that didn't. I don't know what they did here in the home box office. And then put a laugh track on it. So it really, really doesn't matter. You know what I mean? I don't give a shit if you do or not. You know what I mean? Thanks for coming. Good night. Thanks for coming.
the release?
Yes, you want to sign that for me, please, Mr. Chase? We'd appreciate it.
A couple of things missing here.
Well, just your signature is all we need.
No, that's not what I mean. There's no mention of the money. There's no mention of money.
We talked about that, didn't we?
Yes, and I'm supposed to be getting paid money. Why am I signing a release where it doesn't say anything about that?
Because we're going to give you cash.
What about this?
Well, aren't you a member of a union?
Yes, I'm a member of the union, but didn't we say workman's comp? I know when I broke this, and you know when I broke this.
Well,
I
didn't
do three or four of those takes on that wheelchair thing or
Mr.
whatever.
Mr. Chase, excuse me. You have medical coverage from a union?
No, you said you were going to pay for the bones that are busted.
I meant that in spirit, that we would treat the show properly.
Okay.
Because I need your
signature.
Now,
this is just a formality then, right? Because I'm going to get the money.
Absolutely. We appreciate it. It'll just speed things along.
All right.
Thank you.
I remember that when... tell me this, because are you almost finished editing?
Yes, we're very close to finishing.
Ooh, did you get the hospital thing, the children?
Not only did we get it, Mr. Chase, I think it might be up for an award.
Boy.
Humanitarian award.
There are a lot of kids there, huh?
Dozens.
Jesus, all sick.
A few are.
I gave away a few bucks there. Incidentally, you retrieved the cash and all? And
yes, I have a check for you for the amount that you gave.
You give me a check for the cash that I gave away.
Right.
And cash without anything here.
Well, that's why I need the release.
It's sticky.
What?
But I'll, and the show looks great?
The show is great.
The day in the life thing was...
It was a great idea. I'm glad that you went
great.
Along with it. It was smart of you to do it. It makes you look real good, believe me.
Well, I mean, once we got out of that place and I was awake, and we could get going. Okay,
just your name.
All right, it's hard with this.
Well,
you guys really have to, you know, because this costs.
Just let us know.
All right, okay.
We're on your side.
Any particular name?
Should have done that in the show.
Now, again, I just signed something. I've just signed something.
Right, can I have that?
And now I realize.
Thank you.
And now
Mr.
I realize
Chase,
what it said on the.
We have to, I have to go back to the studio. And we appreciate
you guys are
appreciate what you've done.
Well, this
and,
is yours. I'm sorry.
Keep it.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Yes, my pleasure. We have to go back, and I want to thank you again. And I'm sure you'll be pleased with everything we did, the way you look, the way your
just
house
please
looks.
Remember, put the music in right, do all the stuff, and remember the tap dancing. I worked for hours on that thing, man. I want to be perfect.
Yes, we have
on
stereo.
The panel,
for that.
I got those taps specially fitted.
We've got stereo for the taps.
Great. I've appreciated it. I've really enjoyed it.
We appreciate it. We enjoyed it.
Okay.
Thank you.
I hope it works out good.
I know it will.
It's, NBC? It's
all the networks,
a prime time thing.
All the networks are vying for it.
Great. I don't know how home box office gets those deals. I'll see you then.
Okay. Good luck.
Nice working with
right.
you. And take it easy.
Ow. Thank you.